Bienvenidos. Mi nombre es Eugenio, trabajo en el equipo de Cenexus y bueno, un poco la idea de hoy es contarles acerca de las cosas que venimos trabajando desde hace un tiempo alrededor de la integración con diferentes productos de SAP. Creo que bien esta charla podría llamarse abriendo los ojos hacia un nuevo mercado, abriendo los ojos a nuestra comunidad de desarrollo, hacia este mercado. Nosotros iniciamos ya los trabajos como partner de SAP ya hace más de 2 años. Y en todo este tiempo hemos ido conociendo de a poco cómo se mueve esta comunidad de clientes de SAP y el potencial que tiene y sobre todo la avidez que hay en este mercado de soluciones de nicho, soluciones empaquetadas. Y ahí es donde creo que nacen muchas de las oportunidades que bueno, hoy por lo menos voy a intentar transmitirles a ustedes como nuestra comunidad de desarrollo con Cenexus, donde tenemos mucho para ofrecer. Repasemos entonces rápidamente.
So let us briefly go over the figures and the SAP market. SAP at present is one of the most important companies in terms of software companies offering business solutions. It's been there for over 20 years, a little bit more than us, but not that much. And in 190 countries, we have generated over 320,000 clients. An interesting thing here is that 80% of these companies are SMEs. It's clear that one of the strategic focus of SAP, and we live that in Orlando in the Sapphire event a few months ago, and they conveyed how much focus they are on this. And there is no doubt that there is a transformation that SAP is living and undergoing, and it's becoming a cloud company. There is an idea of getting their data to the new platform. So the idea today is to find out the opportunities that we can see from the experience and from the contact we are having, and to try and convey to you where we can take advantage of all this and how. If you ask me where to focus on, well, we've worked on these three big areas. ERP, SAP ERP, which well means that we've developed a connector to simplify the integration through GeneXus through ERP. The GeneXus version 15 have allowed us to develop apps through GeneXus, and that executes the platform as an SAP business. And this is HANA, SAP HANA. We would like to tell you something about what we've been working on, and the new upgrades of version 15.
This upgrade is related to the integration with Business One, which is the smallest RP, which is, I would say, the smallest offer from SAP for small businesses. So we believe that in these three fields, there are various opportunities. And of course, the intersection between the three of them will also bring new opportunities. So this is an invitation to bring in new ideas. Hopefully, we will find them together. And I hope that what I will mention here will not be a full list of possibilities. Now, the connector can be used as from the Evolution 3. It was released about 1 year ago. And it is a very simple idea, a way of exploring the API of the ERP. And it's a way also of extending the ERP and also the offer of SAP in this direction. It's One possibility is to offer all of the niche solutions that our communities has integrated from the ERP and offer them to the market. I was speaking to our Brazilian partner recently, and he has software for supermarket suppliers. He already has a Genex solution for tablets, an application that functions offline to take supermarket orders. And of course, the software is in the used by the administration of the supermarket, and when his sales force increased, he saw that some of their clients had the SAP ERP, and then talking to him, we decided that he needed to have the information so that when orders are synchronized, automatically they are also synchronized with the SAP ERP. So with a very little work and a small investment, the Nexus solution that was already working in other platforms can be integrated with the ERP and from there have access to new clients. Obviously, there are opportunities also for those who develop tailor-made services. And of course, these SAP clients have the need to be integrated to other systems, whereas internal or from their partners. And there we have also the opportunity to offer competitive solutions if we compare them with what these clients are used to having. Another opportunity is extending. There's no software in the world that is so generic that it can solve all of the special features of every single business. And if we extrapolate this to Latin America and SMEs, for sure it would be impossible. So there's an opportunity for us here to identify what are the needs that are not covered by the ERP and create the applications that we can offer through this market. We made the certification process of the connector, and this helped us a lot, obviously, so that when we stand in front of an SAP client, we can state this. The fact of having the SAP certification stamp for these clients is very important. So I recommend that you go along this way with the solutions that you have or can develop. And this will also allow you to present the product you have through the SAP marketplace. So these are opportunities that you can use right now, from Evolution 3 to the Genexus 15 version. Now, the news come with the 15th version and the possibility of supporting this platform as a service. This is what SAP is promoting, and it's the basis of its strategy and its own digital transformation that is going on within SAP. They are trying to be no longer an ERP solution company, but a company that offers a platform as a service, and of course the ERP will be within this platform. As a community, since we see things from the outside many times, let me give you some terminology. When we talk about SAP HANA, we are referring to the database that SAP offers in memory database, on which it has been building all this generation of products and basing its own platform as a service. When we say SAP HANA, it's HCP, it's a service platform where we'll be able to host applications developed in Java, HTMLS, or HANA XS, which is what SAP is offering for these platforms. And obviously, the HANA database runs here, and the new version of ERP, the HANA also works in this platform, the S4. So this is to be aligned with you so that we all mean the same thing when we talk about HANA and SAP. For us, a very interesting announcement that happened in a keynote in of a similar event in Orlando is what they call the API Business Hub. It's one more service within this platform, but what they are doing is offer the extensibility of all their products through services, through Orata services. So I'll tell you in a minute why this new service within this platform is interesting. What does GeneXus 15 offer at the moment? We work in something that is already available in version 15 in the HANA support. Armi mentioned it. It also was said during the keynote. So those of you who already work with GeneXus, the fact of using the database and memory and benefit from the data volume, the form, etc., is the same thing that we are doing up to now, working with GeneXus in the same way, but now we are going to support also this database. And also, we have made the deploy automatic, that is to say, the applications we use in the GeneXus towards the SAP cloud. And this is not a minor functionality. We are turning GeneXus into a tool that accelerates the adoption of this platform. It's an accelerator so as to take the same applications we have very easily to the platform. Another point on which we are working, and you will see novelties in the next upgrades of version 15, is integration through Orata services. This goes beyond SAP, but follows the previous announcement. For us, it's important because through GeneXus, very easily, we will be able to ensure the extensibility and be aligned to what SAP is doing right now with regard to the extensibility of its products. What are the opportunities we see about HCP? I would like to establish some context and put myself in the shoes of the SAP client. He's in previous versions, previous tool for HANA, and knows that by the end of 2025, the maintenance of the previous versions will end. He has a deadline to take into account. These clients, in order to extend the ERP, up to now had been doing developments in a code that is a proprietary code of ERP. And these versions will have to migrate to this platform. Therefore, they will have to learn new programming languages and a new database. And besides, they will have to solve the deploy of whatever they do to this cloud. So this is a bit the script of the problem that many SAP clients are facing. How can they help? How can we help them? Well, basically, by offering them GeneXus. With only one tool at the moment, we can develop applications, either web or mobile, make them connect to the ERP and use HANA as a database and make them run in the HCP cloud. So we have the tool with which we can offer the guarantee that what they do today will run on this platform. Bear in mind that these companies have to make decisions in the next 9 years about how they will continue developing. And at some times, they will need to migrate. But right now, they need to continue innovating and developing applications. And with GeneXus, we can assure them that whatever they want to do can be run in this platform. And if they can't do it or won't do it today because of their own decision, they know that sooner or later, what they do with GeneXus can be migrated very easily to this platform. Another interesting opportunity we see for those who already have niche solutions and want to go to a SaaS modality, software services, is the possibility of packaging their GeneXus solutions so that they run in this platform and market them through the HCP cloud. And besides being a gain because of the subscription that you do, the subscription will give you 75% of what the client pays for these a part of the cloud. So this is a strong, aggressive offer from SAP in order to have migrations to the cloud, and it's good for us who already have solutions and that we are marketing as SAS, but also for others that are interested in going in that direction. And now I would like to invite Andrea Lindemeyer, Director of the Platform Partner Ecosystem for Latin America. We've been working a lot with Andrea, and now she's going to tell us what we are doing jointly.
Hola, buenas tardes.
Good afternoon.
Yo vengo de Brasil,
I come from Brazil, so I excuse myself for my Portuñol. Ask me if there's anything you don't understand. I am the director of a membership program for the development of SAP applications. In this program, companies develop apps using our technology, and this is for Latin America. GeneXus has been part of our program for a long time, and now with the version that generates codes for platforms, it's even more interesting for us within our ecosystem. SAP changed its strategy a few years ago. They don't want to be acknowledged only as the enterprise they were in the past. They also want to be the company that works with platforms, the cloud, and not only the ERP platform. So, company. So the HANA Cloud platform was created within this context. It's a platform in the cloud where applications can be created and developed and do many other things too. It was created as a development platform, which is the most strategic one in the world, and it's an SAP platform. I'm not going to enter into detail about the HANA Cloud platform, but I'll just tell you that it's very powerful, and this is what my partners, our partners tell us every day. It's very easy to use, and it's very fast. Basically, you can do three things in HANA Cloud Platform. Extend the SAP products, that is to say, create new functionalities for the SAP products, like Hybris, SuccessFactors, Yori, and others. Other products such as this one, HANA, other SAP products. You can create new functionalities in these products. That is what we call extend. Then you can integrate. Create integrators of apps, whether they are SAP or not, because it's an open platform. So when you are working with HANA Cloud Platform, you can focus or target the ERP of SAP and the SAP backend and other backends. And finally, you can create applications that can be integrated to backends. That is to say, you can create products. In this context, and since it's part of the DNA of SAP to work with partners, because they can very well develop all the products and buy all the companies, they are not going to win every single market like that. Well, we count a lot on our partners, and in this new platform strategy, we want to reach markets through our technology. So in this context, we created the membership program, created a program for the development of applications in which the partners are going to use all the power of the platform to develop their own apps. And the intellectual property belongs to the partner, not SAP. So basically, the partner receives three packages of resources to develop and monetize apps. The first package is a technology, the technical package, so to speak, because the partner receives all the development environment in order to work in the development of the solutions. The second one is training and support, because the partner in this program receives or gets access to all of our training portals, webinars, questions and answers, sessions with specialists, events, everything the partner needs to train in the use of the technology, and the support of a professional that we call partner service advisor, who is going to help the partner to be more productive and take advantage of the membership. And the third resources package is what we call the go-to-market resources. After having developed the apps, these apps are published in our SAP App Center, and we help you, that is to say the partners, to create demand for the applications. So there are various initiatives and activities that SAP will be working on with you to create demand for the product. Why? Well, because for SAP it's very important and strategic to position HCP that comes with the app. So the partners in these programs are very much aligned with SAP's strategy, and SAP wants to work with the partners because the partners become important vectors to promote the platform. There are three ways of selling the applications created through this program. The first one would be with an SAP professional. So you can work together, for example, with a salesperson or a specialist in the industry. And when you sell, the SAP professional will sell the HCP, and you, the partners, will sell your intellectual property right, which is the app. The second way of doing it is working with partner resellers. There is a membership program in SAP for partners who want to sell SAP products. These partners also want to sell HCP. That is to say, if you work together with one of these partners and you make a sale together, the reseller will sell the HCP and you will sell your app. And the third way of doing it, the third possibility that Eugenio mentioned, is the embedded platform as a service model, that is to say the eBaaS, which allows these partners, as they are working with intellectual property, to sell together as a package the HCP and their app. And SAP is going to produce the productive environment in our cloud to execute the app so that the client has all the resources with the security of the SAP cloud. So the companies that work with GeneXus can also work with SAP in these various modalities. And with our membership, we decided to launch a campaign to show more in detail what we cannot show in a 10-minute talk. How you can work using GeneXus and SAP, or GeneXus and HCP. So let's start with Brazil, because we have to start in some place. It's impossible to show all the markets now. And here there are several milestones to follow. The first one is our general webinar. Everybody is going to receive invitations in Brazil, and we will describe in detail this initiative. Then there will be a second webinar with more technical details from the Hanacop platform as from GeneXus. The idea is that the interested parties present ideas of apps or use cases using both technologies, and then they are going to have a hands-on training with specialists from the HANA platform and GeneXus so that they can start working on a day-to-day basis and develop apps using both technologies. I am positive that this is a huge opportunity, both the membership program as this campaign. I'm going to be here throughout the event, and I will be very happy to discuss all this with you more in depth. I just wanted to show you here this wonderful opportunity with a new market and a new way of working with GeneXus and also with SAP. These are two big and great companies which have a very significant market share. So together, we are going to have a lot of innovation and create opportunities. Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Andrea. So to close this part, I would like to thank Andrea and SAP. This is just an example of the commitment we have with SAP and an invitation to the GeneXus community to explain their cases and start working together. And finally, I wanted to give you a quick overview of what we intend to do with the smaller ERP. Business One is a market that is growing. Last year, they included more than 50,000 new clients, and now in Latin America they have reached 9,000 clients with a two-digit growth rate. This is public information that you can easily find. Without any doubt, it's an emerging market, and here in Latin America we have many of these kind of companies to which we can contribute a lot as a development community. What is the opportunity we'll see? Well, it's more or less the same. This is a smaller ERP that gives more opportunity to compete with different solutions. And we've seen many cases of success in our community offering niche solutions for this market segment. We are working on the Business One version for HANA, and we are doing the integration through ODATA. Our objective is to map with ODATA the data model of Business One so that those of you who work with GeneXus use this data model just as a transaction. That is to say, the same way of working with GeneXus we've had so far. So we have a interesting technical challenge in front of us, and in the next upgrades you will have news about version 15. One example of this is Valkymia. It's an Argentinian warehouse that has been working with GeneXus. They have adopted, I think, that all of our products, and when they saw that we were working hand in hand with SAP, they got close to Business One in Argentina and made a commercial agreement. And today, the salespeople of Business One in Argentina, when they see a client that needs a system to manage fleets, for example, or warehouses, or vehicle control, which are the solutions that Valkymia is offering with Business One, well, they offer them. This is the kind of opportunities that I believe that we as a community can offer to all this market. And to sum up, we are convinced that there are many opportunities out there, much more than the ones we see here at the moment. GeneXus can be seen as a tool that allows to adopt this new platform, but also allows SAP clients to move among these ones, from the biggest to the smallest ERP and everything that is going towards this new platform. So this is an invitation to take advantage of these new opportunities, and as our friend Bill Gates said, big opportunities are born from taking advantage of small opportunities. So please get in touch with me on a case-by-case basis. That's how we work with the connector. We try to make sure that all these cases that are adopting the new technologies are successful, and we are very much interested in seeing this success. This is a way of growing in a market that for us is completely new. Although there are many software houses and clients that are shared with SAP. So this is an open invitation, and we are at your disposal. Thank you very much.